Hey, this is Wes with Baron Heating and BaronGreenTeam.com. Starting you off, this is a, gosh, I almost forget how many zones. I think it's five or six. New construction. But everything's concealed. So I want to tell you, kind of show you what's possible. This is a complete retrofit, remodel, giant house. This system is about 100, well, it's about 90 grand. But it's two VRV systems, light commercial. It's integrated into a Crestron building management system, and a three and a four ton unit, so 7 tons of heating and cooling. This is a Daikin air handler that goes on that. So you have that's being ducted to other spots of the house. We have a Mitsubishi AC for the server room. I know it's mounted low. We had a waiver on that, and we're not too worried about the room. We just need to keep the edge off. So we got that. The coming in turret room, nothing exciting there. But just coming back in, you know, nooks and crannies. We've got another air handler, an ERV, and another concealed unit that's running that back part of the house over here. So these are all individual pod zones. This is what you kind of expect as far as return grills, supplies, etc. Go down. We're on the third floor. So those units up there are all running to... Oh, you guys getting all finished?
Yeah.
Done? Okay, I'll be out of here. Here. Got registers there. Painters want to start, so I'm going to get out of here, go downstairs. But everything from the third floor is feeding the third and second floor. And downstairs, our zones, it was very difficult. But we've got this is a concealed unit up here. So you can see we got return pulling out of this side. There's gonna be an access panel here. Then we've got our high velocity throws here. Coming in to this space, we're throwing here, returning there. We've got our concealed unit up in there. And then those ones up on the third floor are feeding down and into the kitchen and the utility room. And this room, it's real rough right now. We haven't finished everything off, but this is a Daikin 2x2. It was the only way to get to this room. This is an old house that was completely redone. So we got a 2x2 feeding the guest room. And I'll take you down another floor. So down into the garage basement. So you notice that, you know, we haven't seen any heads, and this is a big place, which is exciting. But down here, this is all radiant floor. And then something that you should consider, we've got a couple different methods of doing ERV. We had an ERV doing the whole house upstairs, but down here we didn't have that ability. So this is a Panasonic room ERV. Bring air in, push air out. It's got two ports on the outside. We also have through the wall now ERVs that are awesome. True Comfo, not comfort, True Comfo. Like, I think Kung Fu, but Comfo. Through the wall ERVs that are amazing. Absolutely amazing. So ask me about those if I've got a project going for you. And then we've got not finished, of course. This house is under like almost, it's under remodel, but also it's like the remodel is within the remodel. So it's like always going. These, we have a couple of Navien MPEs tied together. Again, venting was the issue. So we're special venting, gas piping. This house has more gas delivery than any other home you've ever had or imagined, as far as millions of BTUs just to the pool and pagodas and, you know, whatever. We got a server room. We're doing ventilation in there. We're not doing cooling, but we're going to do ventilation in that room. And I'll take you out and show you the outdoor units. Of course, this isn't done, so it's not as exciting, but at least you were able to see the rough end parts of it. And again, even that was just so tight and so intricate. Bye, Jace. Coming over here. We don't have our Mitsubishi outdoor here yet because the ground isn't ready. But that'll be on a stand over here. And then you got your 3 and 4 ton VRV. And you see the stub out over there. That's where our Mitsubishi is going to be. And that's running separate cooling. Everything's tied into Crestron management system, building management, so there's no thermostats on the walls whatsoever. All the units are doing their own temperature sensing, which is feeding back to the Crestron system, which is then, you know, like everything in this house is on that. So if you can imagine a commercial building that has all their stuff tied back to one server, that's what this building basically is, but in the guise of a residential space. So hopefully I'll have another one, you know, when everything's done, but just keep your mind open. You know, when you're looking at these types of systems, almost anything is possible. This was completely impossible to heat from a traditional system standpoint, and this was the only way that we were able to provide heating and cooling to all the spaces in this house. Thanks for watching.